especially how last episode ended, setting us off on this next, I don't know, arc, or at least things we're going to be doing set inside the plan in motion. This one being called The Congress Dances has me confused. What Congress is dancing? What's up, Dapper Squad? It's your boy Darius back at it again with Reincarnated as a Slime, Season 2, Episode 16. Like I said, this one's called The Congress Dances. Last episode, we ended our extraordinary meeting with monsters and humans, and we ended up not only having Blummond, Dworgen, and technically Falmouth as well, because we have Yume, but we also have Talion with Arald officially giving us his good graces, welcoming us, you know, into this alliance and stuff like that. And then we ended off kind of strongly saying how we need to deal with Clayman, and he's our main antagonist right now. And then we saw Clayman meeting with Laplace, and they were talking about their next steps and their plans. Don't overstep things, be careful, be cautious. And it made Clayman feel like he's not necessarily 100% on top of things. So I'm very curious where this is gonna go. I'm very excited. Don't forget, if you guys want early access and full length to this show and all the other shows I'm watching, we are 4 episodes ahead on Patreon. Links are down below for you guys, like always. Don't forget to subscribe and click that bell so you guys always know when I post over here on the Dapper channel. Follow all the social medias, Instagram, Twitch, TikTok, Twitter, all at DapperDarius. Much appreciated, you guys. Let's hop into this. That time I got reincarnated as a slime. Season 2, Episode 16, The Congress Dances. Let's do this. Thus, the very long meeting between humans and monsters ended. Or so we thought. Yeah, we never really did get Ramurus' warning, did we? She knocked out last episode. That's the drone thing that, yeah, the golem that you made. That when you destroyed the other one, yep. Yeah, I'm a little curious. Rimuru, there are so many characters I remember. Who is the heroine gonna choose? I don't know. Yeah, just spoil it, Rimuru. Yes, but why? You did say that before, but why? That has been mentioned a few times. Does that include Rimuru? Because we're a newly formed demon lord? Ooh, a great war? Now, correct me if I'm wrong. Especially because you guys corrected me a lot when Rimuru turned into the demon lord, you know, with the whole religious aspect with Raphael Beelzebub. People told me I don't know how to pronounce that. I'm sorry. But correct me if I'm wrong, but Walpurgis, however you pronounce it, is also some sort of religious Day of Reckoning type day. Only reason I say that, wasn't that the name? It's been years since I've seen this show. Wasn't that the name of also like a Day of Reckoning in Madoka Magica? Wasn't it called Walpurgis, or like the enemy was called, I don't know why I'm thinking of that, but I swear I don't know how to pronounce it. I'm so bad, guys. I'm sorry, but correct me. Let me know. I love getting all the info from you guys. So that's just what they say, though. That will lead to war. And that's a great rebuttal. Who's working with him? Yeah, both. They're all mad at Milim and Frey for what happened to Eurazania. Yeah, that's my homegirl Mu Khan back there. We killed Mulan, you know. It is a huge deal, and we're acting calm though because we're also powerful. Yeah, Mulan's right there. Huh? What are these faces Ramurus is making? Yeah, what are you putting the whole story two and two together? Yeah. Okay, Ramorous. Okay. Is it soon? 3 days. Oh, that's super soon. Beretta. I didn't know that was the name of the drone. I'm gonna write that down. Never know when we'll see Ramorous again, you know? Shouts out you. I appreciate that. Oh, that would actually be kind of cool. We can visit Ramorous more often. Reincarnated as a slime bath scenes. Top tier. Always have been. Yeah, Trainee and Treya sisters. They like support Rimuru, right, as the Queen of Spirits, something like that. We've been doing that so far. We've been building crazy roads. Yeah, he is kind of implying that. Yeah, so they do the work, but they also get fair money for it. That also makes sense, depending on how we're doing with the said contract, said alliance, you know? That's a fair deal. I like that, you know? Harald's over here making Italian deals. I like it. Over sake in a hot spring? I want to make all my deals with sake in a hot spring from now on. Nothing else. Oh my god, that dinner looks incredible. We're having like a feast. I've always wanted to wear like a kimono and sit in like a traditional Japanese room and like kneel. They have a hibachi restaurant relatively near me that has like a super traditional room that you have to like rent out and you sit like that and everything. Oh, I would love that. That'd be so sick. I'd actually be down for Ramorous to help out. I always love having big, strong, powerful allies, you know? Look at that! Okay, oh my god, that man looks so drippy. Eating everything. Hold on. What happened to their eye? That is so blurred that I'm trying to even. Raheem got fucked up and Maris got oh my. Nickel spoon? Cardinal Nicholas Spurtus. Okay, Fuse, shake them up. That's dope. We're going on, not on the offensive technically, but we're laying our foot down. Yes, hell yeah. Shouts out to our new allies. Yeah, who was it? Rosin? Yeah, I thought Diablo murdered that man. Oh, okay. So it is. What's the guy who took Rosin's body? I'm trying to remember. I don't know, guys. There's a lot of names in the show. I am so sorry, but the old man, you know who I'm talking about. It was him. Yeah, he survived. I didn't know that. He was very strong. Rosin, yes. So he's well known. Yeah, that is 100% what happened. They just don't know because body switches and stuff like that. But is it Rosin? Because I like I said, there's a lot of names in this. Shogo is the one who died, right? And he took over Shogo's body. Or am I crazy? Because some of these names that I have written down in my handwriting is just be horrible, you know? So I just double checked my notes real quick, and my notes were completely wrong. It seems Rosin was the magic user. It was Kyoya who was the guy who Hakuro chopped his head off at like 1/1000th speed. Shogo was the mad one. Kirara was the girl who's obviously Kirara. But I gotta write down Kyoya because I don't know. For some reason, I had Rosin as the third otherworlder summoned by Falmouth over here. But no, I am 100% incorrect. Rosin was the magic user who I believe took over Shogo's body and then I thought had died to Diablo, but no, is alive, was questioned, we'll say, and now everyone's talking about how hyped he was. I'm not gonna lie, compared to our current characters, yes, he's a weakling, he's nowhere near as strong, but in terms of a normal human and a magic user, a Majin, he is very strong, so I can see why his name would have this notoriety and have been spread throughout the land and stuff like that. I'm just super interested and curious, and my notes were horribly wrong, so I apologize, guys. He was pretty crazy. That, like, destruction magic that he used? Yes. I can't wait to see Diablo in action. I love how Soe does that every time Rimuru calls him. He looks new. Oh my god, his sword looks dope. Yamza is known. Oh, he has a squad called the Five Fingers. Oh, I gotta get all these names down during editing. A fox, what the hell? Pirone? She looks like a harpy from Yu-Gi-Oh. That's what I was saying. That sword looks dope. The Magic Swordsman of Ice. It's a fire name. That's a good point. Also, Benimaru, your kimono looks fucking fire. He did say he wanted Eurazania, that whole land, all the people. Yep. I love how Raphael can almost damn near deduce anything. Like, I love it. Damn that Clayman. Don't end right here. Don't. Oh, man. I want to finish this whole season out right now. You have no idea. Well, that was a fantastic setup episode. Very excited where this is going to go. Very excited to get some info about Walpurgis, or Valpurgis, however it's pronounced. I like how there's an actual realism behind it, but it's also like there's an old fairy tale behind it. You know, it's like it's said that once every however many years, all the demon lords will get together and it will lead to a great war. And Ramirez is like, it does happen, but it's kind of just like an annual meeting. You know, we kind of discuss what we do, what we did, what we need to do. A lot of the times it doesn't necessarily lead to war. But the reason it's so dangerous in this case is because three of the demon lords who started this Walpurgis and are working together are going to be talking about Jura, Tempest Federation, and how we can deal with them. So that's very interesting. Very interesting. I am very curious about Walpurgis, about this battle, about the war, about Clayman taking over Eurazania, all that jazz. It was cool seeing Beretta again. It was cool seeing Ramirez and Beretta total, but Beretta's personality and how much she like helps Ramirez, it's very funny. Very funny. But Ramirez is heavily talking about moving into this area, which would be so sick, you know. Having an entrance to the spirit dwelling here would be nice, and the fact that Trainee and Tria are like subordinates of Ramirez makes them the perfect assistance to this whole situation, and they love it too, so I, you know, I'm down. She could easily move in. It'd be fun just having her as like comedy relief, you know, all that. The meeting was super fun. It was great having the confidence in our new allies like Fuse, Gazelle, and Erald, that they're willing to say, I'm gonna go home, do this to help you guys out, shake up the enemies, and hopefully they tread more lightly, and you know, we're gonna announce our, I just love that, like, they can so boldly say, I got your back, you got, like, it's no, like, Game of Thrones type shit, where it's all shady, under, you know, under dealings, all this, like, they're boldly saying, these are my allies, don't fuck with them. And I always respect that. I really do. And I think every deal or negotiation being made should be done with a great dinner in kimonos. And before that, in a hot spring with sake. Like, if someone's trying to buy, let's say I'm a merchant, I'm selling goods, and someone's haggling, you know, and they offer me kind of a low price. Like, normally I wouldn't take it. But if I got a little sake in me and I'm over here relaxing a hot spring after I ate some fucking tempura shrimp with some, you know, like, there's just no way I'm saying no. Like, all right, dog, this is, all right, you got a deal, you know, like, I'm gonna start taking that, you know, like when I get a copyright strike and I'm trying to convince YouTube to take it off and to bring me back and to let it down, I'm gonna take them into a hot tub, give them some sake. You know, we're thinking over here, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode. If you did, please leave a like. Let me know your thoughts down below. Like always, don't forget to subscribe and click that bell so you guys always know when I post over here on the Dapper channel. Follow all the social medias, Instagram, Twitch, TikTok, Twitter, at DapperDarius. Don't forget to check out that Patreon for early access and full length if you guys don't want to wait for the next bunch of episodes. Don't forget to drink some water. Be safe. Tell someone you love them. Have a great day, Dapper Squad. Peace.